Before you start entering transactions, you should prepare the reports so that you can check the results of your transactions immediately. There are only two reports that you need if you're using QuickBooks for your home and personal finance. The trial balance is the first one. The trial balance and the profit and loss are the only two reports that you need, and I will explain each of them separately right here in this video. The results of the accumulated totals in your chart of accounts will all show up on your main report, the trial balance. So when you record transactions, it will be recorded into one or more of these accounts. Each of these accounts is a record of transactions that relate to that account, and the accumulated totals show up here in the trial balance as the ending balance. Let's take a look how to open it up. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Notice the trial balance opens up with only one number, zero. And that's because we have not yet recorded any transactions into the file. As soon as we start recording transactions, the numbers will show up here and accumulate. You might also notice that you're able to put in a from date and a to date in the top of the trial balance. In a future video, I will show you how to set a from date and a to date so that you can see in the body of the report only the results of transactions between those dates. For example, I would click from May 10 to May 17, and then if I clicked refresh, I would see accumulated totals from only transactions that have a date between the from and the to date. And again, we'll review this later. The best way to set up your trial balance now is to ask QuickBooks to show you the results of all transactions, regardless of date. The way to do that is to click the top left pull down arrow and scroll all the way up to the very top choice and click All. Now the trial balance will show you the results of all transactions, regardless of date, and you can change the dates later. Now let's go ahead and add it to the icon bar. In the top left of the main menu, click View, and then click Add Trial Balance to the icon bar. Then click OK, and notice we have our shortcut. When you click to close the trial balance, you will get a one-time pop-up message asking you to memorize the report. We will not need this, so click the Don't Bother Me box, and then click No, and that message will no longer pop up. You will notice if we click to open the trial balance from the icon bar, it looks exactly the way it looked at the moment we saved it to the icon bar. Now let's take a look at the profit and loss. From the main menu, click Reports, Company and Financial, Profit and Loss Standard. Notice this also has a from date and a to date that you can adjust. The best way to save this to your icon bar is to click the date pull-down choice and scroll all the way to the top. Click A for All. This way, the profit and loss will show you the results of all transactions, regardless of date. To save it to the icon bar, click View, Add Profit and Loss to the icon bar, and then click OK. Now, all you have to do is click the shortcut, and the difference between your income and expenses will show here in the profit and loss. Before you enter your first transaction, you really should adjust the icon bar for your convenience. I suggest the following order. To the left, you should have your setup windows. This is where your permanent information is, like your chart of accounts, your customer information, and your vendor information. Right in the middle, you should have your transaction windows. Those are the different registers that you would record transactions into. To the right of those, you should have your reports so you can check your results immediately after you record transactions. Then all the way to the right, you should have windows that we will open in a future video that are tools for helping you find things like past transactions or mistakes. Let's take a look how to do this in the icon bar. From the main menu, click View, Customize Icon Bar. Now notice we want to move the Vendors and Customer window all the way to the left by the chart of accounts so you can have all your permanent setup information in one place. If you scroll up just a little bit, you will be able to move right next to the word Vendors. Click on the diamond in the left margin and you'll do a click and drag motion. Click and drag it up. Notice as you drag it up, well, hold on, let's try it again. Click. Now notice, as you drag it up, you get the different shape mouse pointer and the line. If you go all the way up above Chase Bank and lift up your finger, you will notice that Vendors has moved all the way to the left. And if you scroll up a little more, you can see that this order corresponds to the order in the icon bar. You must click OK to save the change. If you click Cancel or Close the window, the change will not save. So again, View, Customize Icon Bar, scroll up just a little bit, click to the left of Vendors and drag it all the way, click and drag all the way above Chase Bank and click OK. Now Vendors is next to the chart of accounts. Now we'll move the Customer window next to the Vendor window. Click View, Customize Icon Bar, and then scroll up a tiny bit, then click on Customers, drag it all the way up between Vendors and Chase Bank and lift up your finger. Now when you click OK, you have your three permanent windows with the permanent information that you use to set up the file and you could always go back to. You can add two separators here between Customers and Chase Bank to tell your eyes it's a different section of the icon bar. Click View, View, Customize Icon Bar. Click right above where you want the separators to be and click Add Separator twice. Then click OK and you can see this is your permanent setup information and here are all the windows you will open when you record transactions. Let's put two separators before and after the reports. Click View, Customize Icon Bar. Click right above the... You're actually clicking on the cash on hand, which is the last transaction window, and then twice click Add Separator. And you can see there's a little partition between your register windows and your reports. Let's scroll down to the bottom of the Customize Icon Bar, click the last icon, and click Add Separator twice. This way, when we get to future videos and add the tools you need for searching, we can put them right at the end here and everything will be organized and clear. Click OK and congratulations, you're ready to record your first transaction.